Good evening. Mother Nature at her unpredictable worst has thrown a spanner in the works on what was supposed to be a day of new beginnings for battle-scarred Melbourne. Wild winds roared in, knocking out power for hundreds of thousands of Victorians and ripping homes and lives apart. Lana Murphy leads off tonight's coverage.
As fast as lightning and just as ferocious, this was the perfect storm to steal Melbourne's freedom thunder. Cracking down on every part of the state, no tree or trampoline was immune.
Pretty sure that's not meant to be there.
There it goes. There it goes.
Forget snow, this storm even caused a styrofoam tsunami. Winds were so strong it toppled dozens of shipping containers at the docks and ripped out 100-year-old roots from the ground.
Oh my God! I just got that on film!
Motorists dodged disaster.
Jesus!
At every turn. While all that home and shed owners could do was watch their work fly away. Sleeping inside this Chelsea bedroom, a 93-year-old great-grandmother woke to a nightmare.
Just can't believe she got out, but it's amazing. Somebody's looking after her.
Alex Weiss's mother survived the Holocaust, but it was the 120 km/h winds near Frankston that nearly took her life. The roof of her home of more than 40 years peeling open like a tin can, remnants landing on active power lines and crushing the family car. She was covered in debris but rescued by her son and a neighbour and somehow escaped without a scratch.
The whole bedroom is just completely gone and she just got out of trouble in time.
One street away, four townhouses were also destroyed, metal piercing neighbouring homes.
It's their roof that's wrapped itself completely around our house and has pierced our roof and crushed our garden shed.
In Port Melbourne, the roof of an apartment complex simply blew away, shards of aluminium hanging precariously before plummeting to the ground.
The wind was howling, like you could hear the building like groaning.
Nearby, cars were crushed.
Enough, I'd been praying for a big storm. I'm a big storm lover, so it's sort of come back to bite me here.
But little compared to the depth of destruction at Ben Owen's cockatoo home, a giant pine tree obliterating the SES controller's property with his wife and two young daughters inside.
They were quite hysterical, obviously. They jumped in my arms and carried him out. The greyhound, I should get smaller dogs, I think, I had to carry the greyhound out the window.
The 18-year volunteer was on his way to help his neighbours when Mother Nature turned the tables on him.
He's painted downstairs and renovated the kitchen and done all that sort of stuff and nearly finished it. It was sort of like the last ISO project to keep us busy, and then there's a big-ass pine tree sitting on top of it now.
His team and colleagues responding to more than 3,000 call-outs.
2,300 of those have related to trees coming down, and 490 have related to building damage.
The helpline so in demand, it was ringing off the hook.
Half of those calls are still outstanding. If you call that number, please be patient.
The wild weather was widespread. It hit Ballarat, the Ballerine and Bendigo first, before wreaking havoc across Melbourne and the Mornington Peninsula, where Portsea recorded gusts of 135 km/h at 7:30 a.m. The strongest gusts were near the Grampians at 143 km/h, but there was damage from Croydon to Cranbourne and Clyde, Eltham to Elwood, Rockbank and Melton. In Airport West, part of a roof gave way. Cars parked metres from the scene untouched.
First the virus, earthquake a few weeks ago, now this the wind doing this to the house. I don't know what could come next.
But around the corner, these ones weren't so lucky. As two workers pulled into the car park, the front of their building collapsed. They were crushed by bricks while sitting in the driver's seat and largely escaped uninjured. The first weekend of tourism drowned out at Lake Eildon, docks giving way, boats thrashed in the elements.
The wind is still intense.
Intensity now settled, and authorities say in coming days will be right as rain.
It's a really good time to get out and check around your property now as the conditions ease up over the weekend. Look out for any of those branches that may still be hanging up.
The long weekend in terms of weather is looking a whole lot more positive.
Lana, a big clean-up effort is underway.
Is it ever, Pete? Here in Tullamarine, the SES members have just arrived to a tree, that branch that has fallen 10 hours ago. They've been run off their feet, working hard since 5 o'clock this morning. The 74-year-old man who lives here tells me that the sound of howling winds overnight prompted him to sleep, not in the front of the room where he would normally be, but at the back of the house, and he's certainly glad he did. These members will be here working long into the night, and there is no doubt, Pete, there is a long, long weekend ahead for many.
Indeed. Thank you very much, Lana Murphy. More than 250,000 Victorians are still without electricity, and it might take days to reconnect. As Mimi Becker reports, widespread destruction has left already devastated businesses unable to open for the weekend.
With no power in a pub, there's no cold beer, so publican Carl Seister is relying on a generator.
I've got it. I've got a little Jenny on board at the moment just to keep the beers cold.
He was set to welcome back more customers tonight as restrictions ease, but now that's not guaranteed.
We just cop everything at the moment. It's very hard, but, we keep battling on.
With the state's power network torn to pieces, at the height of the wild winds, 526,000 Victorians were left without power.
Key areas that still remain off supply, the Dandenong Ranges, the southeastern Melbourne suburbs, Geelong to Apollo Bay and Ballarat.
While crews work to restore the network, residents and businesses are being warned it could be days.
It could be another 24 hours, it could be 6 hours, but it could be longer.
It's tough. It was tough.
In Cardinia, Isaac Arwit has had to throw out stock from his convenience store that won't last.
We lost the business today and probably a lot of other people's, so what else we can do?
With no power, it was back to home learning at Xavier College while school was cancelled at Beacon Hills College in Pakenham. VCE students missing their biology exam before the power was restored in time for maths this afternoon.
So it's really only on those days that we aren't able to have power to bring the kids in that we need to make that really tough decision to look at an alternate program.
For this worker in Port Melbourne, it was a double whammy, not only losing power to his business, but his car, a casual
I'm shook.
The pain for those without power will be felt across the weekend.
Trying to get as many as we can connected as soon as possible. It may take several days. Our crews are dealing with challenging situations such as strong winds, trees continue to fall.
Trams, trains and buses were all caught in the chaos.
No part really of our transport network has escaped unscathed today. You know, we've seen fallen trees and debris causing some widespread damage there.
And Mimi has the latest on public transport from Ringwood Station. Mimi, several train lines still impacted.
They are, Pete. Buses are replacing trains on 8 lines across the network, including the Sunbury, Craigieburn and Belgrave-Lilydale lines. It's understood this could be for some days as specialist crews need to inspect the tracks before they can be deemed safe. There's also significant delays across the entire network, and that goes for trams too. So passengers are being asked to exercise extra patience, allow for more time and to check for updates online, Pete.
Mimi Becker, thank you.